Queensland is waking up under flash flood warnings. Already this morning, rivers across the southeast are turning into torrents, the SES pulling dozens of residents from the water.
Nine Queensland reporter Bailey Kenzie is in Oxenford Weir. Bailey, good morning. You've just had an update from the Weather Bureau.
Yeah, Clint, they've updated that severe weather warning in the last half hour or so for areas including Burnett, Wide Bay, Brisbane and the Gold Coast. The forecast is possible isolated 24-hour rainfalls of 350 millimetres. Of course, just yesterday in areas of the Gold Coast like Springbrook, it reached up to 500 millimetres of rainfall. Of course, with that brought a number of emergency services rescues right here on the Gold Coast, including at Natural Bridge. 44 people were rescued on a private property at 10 o'clock last night, and in the 24 hours there were 10 swift water rescues here on the Gold Coast, and a similar situation in far northern New South Wales with 13 swift water rescues. Clint, emergency services spoke to Today on Nine a short time ago. Here's what they had to say.
What we're seeing is a lot of flash flooding, creeks and catchments rising really quickly. Overnight we've undertaken at least another 10 swift water rescues. We've had to evacuate people from campgrounds, and the Bureau's advising us today we could see fall still another 350 millimetres today.
Quick spurts of intense rainfall, the river systems, creeks and roadways, the flooding is rising very quickly and catching people unaware. So we're really asking people to maintain their awareness around their roadways and river systems.
Clint, we're coming to you live from the Oxenford Weir this morning, and as you can see, these waters really are moving quite quickly, and the advice from authorities is to stay far away from them, especially for motorists. Clint, the advice is if you're driving near floodwaters, forget it.
Bailey Kenzie reporting live for us. Thanks so much. And the SES is being kept really busy south of the border as well, responding to 115 incidents across New South Wales flooded northeast in the past 24 hours alone. 27 of those were for flood rescues in the Northern Rivers region. No significant injuries have so far been reported. That region has been impacted by heavy rain, exceeding 300 mils at Limpenwood and 200 mils in many other parts.
Southeast Queensland and Northern New South Wales residents are being urged to stay alert as severe thunderstorms and heavy rainfall batter parts of the east coast.
For more on this story, we're joined this morning by SES Deputy Zone Commander Scott McLennan in Lismore. Scott, thanks for your time. How are conditions looking outside at the moment?
Outside this morning here in the Northern Rivers, the situation is actually settling somewhat. The severe weather warning that was issued by the Bureau was rescinded this morning, which is good news for some of the residents in and around the Northern Rivers, but we are starting to see some of the impacts of riverine flooding.
So we know that there are more areas that are expected to face flash flooding, and it is a type of year when you have lots of holiday makers up in the area, lots of people camping as well. How should people best prepare for this?
So yesterday we actually had 27 flood rescues, and that was primarily due to a lot of people being caught out due to flash flooding. So either camping on riverbanks or actually driving through flash flood known areas. That requires all of us just to be a bit more vigilant about where we set up our camps and making really good, strong decisions about where we should travel or if we should travel at all.
Scott, there's more help on hand if you guys need it. I understand the ADF was on standby last night. Are they likely to be deployed today?
So the ADF are on standby for southeast Queensland. I can only talk about what's happening here in the Northern Rivers in New South Wales. We are positioned and very well poised to assist all the communities here in the Northern Rivers. And we are working with all of our partner agency, whether that be Marine Rescue, New South Wales Police, or the RFS and Surf Life Saving.
Sure.
We all remember what happened in Lismore. What is it like for you and for residents there when you do get these sorts of warnings?
These sorts of warnings are a testament just to how resilient the community is here in Lismore and the surrounding areas. So it just wasn't Lismore that flooded a couple of years ago. It was actually the whole region. Anytime it does rain and anytime we put these warnings out, we're actually giving the community a lot of time and a lot of notice to actually take control of the situation, start preparing their properties, start preparing themselves. The more that they can do for themselves, the less anxiety that they can actually build.
All right, Scott, thank you so much for your time on the Today Show. We really appreciate it, and best of luck today.
In the last 24 hours, Queensland's State Emergency Service has received over 700 calls as communities in the state southeast are caught off guard by flash floods. Joining us now is QFES Deputy Commissioner Kevin Walsh for more. Deputy Commissioner, thank you for your time. Can you just bring us up to speed? What's the latest on this emergency?
So we've got intense rainfall, obviously, in the Gold Coast and Scenic Rim. We've had up to 500 millimetres in some locations in the Gold Coast over the last 24 hours. So the ground is absolutely saturated. And what we're seeing is with quick spurts of intense rainfall, the river systems, creeks and roadways, the flooding is rising very quickly and catching people unaware. So we're really asking people to maintain their awareness around their roadways and river systems and keep listening to the alerts as they are issued throughout the day.
You've, of course, had hundreds of calls for help just in the last 24 hours, but you've had 4,000 since Christmas. Such a strain on resources. How are you handling all these rescues?
Yeah, we've still got a support from New South Wales and Victoria. So New South Wales, Victoria both sent SES and CFA volunteers. So we've got them on the ground assisting our local resources. And since that period of time, we've been on the ground helping the community. And they'll be out there again today. They're very motivated to try and get as much work as they can. Obviously, yesterday with the storms interrupted their progress a little bit, but they're already out on the roads today and we'll be assisting with that work.
Such an anxious time for so many people in the southeast. What is your advice for those currently in those flooded regions?
So my advice is very simple and that is maintain listening to the media, listening to the alerts, and certainly don't take any unnecessary trips out on the road this morning. If you need a reason to go out, it's got to be a really compelling reason to get out on the road this morning. But obviously in the Gold Coast hinterland is where that saturation is most. So people just got to maintain their awareness around those areas.
Yeah, good advice. Deputy Commissioner, thank you so much for your time.
Queensland residents right now can't seem to catch a break, can they? Relentless rain causing more and more road closures and emergency rescues across the state's southeast. For more on this, we are joined this morning by Queensland Deputy Commissioner of Police Shane Chalepi in Kedron. Shane, good morning. Thanks for your time. People in these regions, they've been through a lot. Have they been able to get outside, assess the damage, or is that rain still coming down?
Oh, good morning. Thank you. No, we're still seeing heavy rain right across the southeast corner. In fact, we're seeing heavy rain all the way from Wide Bay to the border. So, we've seen falls in the last 24 hours of up to 250 millimetres in a six-hour period. And the Bureau's advising us today we could see falls still another 350 millimetres today.
Which is both devastating and frustrating, Shane. What do people in that region need right now? What sort of support?
Look, it's been hard. It's been hard since Christmas Day. A number of our communities in the Scenic Rim, Logan, Gold Coast area were just starting to recover and move into, the recovery process since Christmas Day, Boxing Day storms. And now we've had this torrential rain. So what we're seeing is a lot of flash flooding, creeks and catchments rising really quickly. Overnight, we've undertaken at least another 10 swift water rescues. We've had to evacuate people from campgrounds. So I really think people need the rain to stop, but to be able to assess the damage. We now know that we had a lot of damage from Christmas Day and Boxing Day storms. That damage is going to be a lot worse.
Even worse, Deputy Commissioner, and this really beggars belief. It makes us angry. There's been reports of looting in some flood-affected areas. That must make your blood boil.
Look, we did have some initial reports of looting up around Mount Tambourine. We're yet to confirm them, but we have put a lot of extra police into the communities. Absolutely. Look, anyone who wants to go out and take advantage of the community when they're at the most vulnerable stage, I think it's an absolutely despicable act, and the police will take a very hard line and we won't take a backward step on that sort of behaviour.
OK, and finally, what sort of assistance is actually available for those whose homes might have been affected by this wild weather ongoing, of course?
Well, a couple of key things today, can I say, is one, please stay in your home, stay off the roads. The emergency services crews are still undertaking a number of swift water rescues. These creeks and catchments are so unreliable, they're coming up and going down so fast with the rain. Secondly, if you are in your home and you need assistance, our SES on 132 500, or of course, if it's life-threatening, call 000. We've had over 700 calls for service in the last 24 hours, and we're here to help.
Yeah, we wish your crews, the SES, and also residents, of course, all the very best. Shane Chalepi, thanks so much for your time on The Today Show.